Welcome back to Birdies Not BS. This week is Solheim Cup week. This is a very big week in golf.
USA.
Of course, we're going to root for USA. But today we're going to talk about Solheim Cup, Ryder Cup. Why are they so fun to watch? Why should we care?
Golf is not that hard.
Well, it doesn't have to be. That's why we cut through all the highbrow golf BS to give you what you really need to know to enjoy the golfing experience.
I'm Doug Smith.
And I'm Cheyenne Woods.
And together we have over 50 years experience playing the game of golf at every level.
Every week we'll break down a new topic in 10 minutes or less, answering some of the most popular questions in golf today.
You're welcome. You know, that's a great question, Cheyenne. Why should we care about these team international competitions? I'll tell you why, because it's about our nation and national pride. You know, it's us coming together as a nation to take on foes on the golf course.
It's very rare that you get to compete head-to-head on a team on the golf course, put paint on your face.
Paint it up.
American flags everywhere.
America.
So it's cool. It's a fun format. I mean, for those who don't know, there are two teams, the USA versus Europe, all of Europe, the UK. I think the teams are made up of 12 people. I definitely need to know that. But it's 3 days of foursomes, best ball, and singles matches.
Singles matches.
Match play.
No, first of all, it's match play golf. That's honestly my favorite format to play. But, you know, as an American growing up here, we don't get an opportunity to play much match play. But when I do get to play match play, I love it. Love it. Eat it up. And that's one of the first things I love about team competition, especially in the international format. It's you got 18 holes. Go out there and get it.
And two, I think as a fan, it's so much more exciting to watch because it is one-on-one. It is the match play. And I think it brings out the best in a lot of golfers. You see some of the most exciting golf highlights when it is the team format and the player has to make the putt on the 16th hole to win the match to retain the cup. It's a different type of pressure than playing for yourself. You're playing not only for your team, your captain, your family, your country.
Country.
You know, you've got the uniform on. So it is. It's exciting to watch. And you could watch with some buddies, cheer for your country.
I almost just said the Pledge of Allegiance just now.
His hand is on his heart.
You know, I'm just saying, like, just listening to you talk about the team format. I mean, why is it exciting? It's exciting to me because it's a chance where you are battling the other player in the name of the team.
Yes.
Like, you know, in golf, we don't get that opportunity much, right? It's usually just us and the individual, and that's it. And it's your team, right? Your publicists and agents and whomever else is your fans. That's the only people that really benefit. In this instance, you get to add to a team, you know, or you lose for the team. And that I love that.
That's a lot of weight. That's a lot of pressure.
Heavy, heavy.
But that's what we play for, and that's what we love about it. Now, this year, the Solheim Cup is in Scotland. So it is on European home turf, whereas last year the U.S. won in Des Moines, Iowa on our home turf.
That's right.
How important do you think that is to where you're playing, who the fans are that are there, what energy is around you? Do you think that that helps or hurts specific teams, whether you're home or away?
You know, when I think about the home or away turf, I like to liken it back to like basketball or football, right? When you go into Ohio State and you're a visiting team, you know that you're going to have 110,000 people rooting against you. You go to Cameron Indoor and you're playing Duke at Duke, you know it's going to be a hostile environment. And that's similar in golf. We Americans, we're going to be on foreign soil, and for them it's going to be a home game, and it's going to be electric out there. And we've got format issues, not format and like how to play the game, but style of golf course format. Americans, we don't play a lot of linksy, wispy, windy conditions. It's going to provide an opportunity for a lot of ups and downs in the matches.
That's a huge part of it as well, is the golf course style, as we saw in the men's last year, where a lot of the Americans struggled playing the golf course that they were competing on.
So Cheyenne, you played this year in the women or in the Scottish Open, and I'm not sure how far away they're holding the Solheim from where you were. But how did you prepare as an American, right, going overseas for that event? Because it should be similar, if I'm not wrong, for the American team.
They're playing in Scotland. I was in Scotland a few weeks ago at the Scottish Open, and links golf is very different. Not only the course design, but the weather is very different for us coming over from, you know, playing all summer in the heat and perfect conditions. Scotland, you never know what you're going to get. It's a windy conditions, rain. There's a lot of slope and undulation. in. So going into a week like that, I work on a lot of punch shots. I work on a lot of bump and runs, putting from off the green. I love links golf because you can be creative and you can just run shots up there and use the natural slope of the golf course. So it is a very different type of strategy, I guess, that goes into playing, but that's what makes it so fun. And especially in this format, I think it'll be really exciting to see how not only the Europeans play on home turf, but how the Americans then translate their games to compete against Europe's best.
Right. So we've talked about the course. We've talked about where they're playing. It's an away game for the American team. Let's talk a little bit about preparation, Cheyenne, because I think you alluded to it a little bit. You're hitting more punch shots. You're hitting more bump and runs. These girls from overseas, they're used to playing that style of golf. So coming here to the States, hitting the ball high and trying to get, you know, more carry distance and things like that. What is the advantage and disadvantage of the American team going over to play against a ready European team?
One advantage I do think that we might have is that the Scottish Open was just a few weeks ago. So it was a little bit of a taste of what they might experience this week as they play again in Scotland. And again, for the European team, obviously they have a huge advantage in growing up in Europe and playing a lot of European style golf. But again, in this environment, it's a little bit different. Anything can happen when the weight of a country or continent, as Europe is on the shoulders. You know, you're playing for a team. It's not just another tournament. It's not just another week on tour. This is a big event.
Do you keep the individual mindset? You know, you go into a LPGA Tour event week in, week out. You've got the mindset of, I've got to play well. I have to prepare. I, me. So when you're in this team format, you've got to almost not say I. It's going to have to now be us. And that's got to be a big difference, especially in the mindset of a golfer.
The only team I've been a part of is my collegiate team, which I played at Wake Forest and I loved college golf. And you're totally right. It is not me, I. I think that's why my team was so successful. We were super close. We had a very strong bond. We wanted to play well, not only for ourselves, but for each other. And going into a week like Solheim Cup or Ryder Cup on the men's side, you see these teams preparing months in advance and getting that team chemistry ready. You're having outings, you're having practice rounds, you're having these team bonding moments. So it's very important so that when you do go into a week like that, you are focused on the team. It is a week about the team, not just you individually. And I mean, two of the 3 days you're playing team formats.
One of the best things about the team format is, yes, we can watch it and be spectators about it, but guess what? We can also bring it into our own lives and we can experience some of those feelings for ourselves. I've got friends that will go on golf trips where they divide themselves into teams of 4, 6, 12 guys, and they play each other in these various formats because you're playing a best ball, you're playing a scramble, and you're playing an alternate shot. Now, you played in a team format earlier this year. How is the alternate shot? What's that pressure like when you've got to hit a shot that might not be in the best of locations and it wasn't your fault that you got there?
Man, alternate shot is the hardest format ever. I mean, it sounds pretty simple because you're only hitting half the shots, but you have to think you're completely out of the rhythm of your natural game. You have the pressure of wanting to put your partner in the best positions. When I was playing in the Dow event, LPGA was the first partner event in a long time. One of our things we always said is there's no saying I'm sorry. No matter what you do, there's no I'm sorry. We're working our best together. Of course, we said I'm sorry because
you're nice people.
It's hard. Because you're nice people. It's hard, but you know, it is difficult. It is a fun format. People can play at home, whether it's golf course versus golf course or just a group of friends playing amongst each other. Try it at home. See how it works. There's so much you can do with this.
Yeah, get out there and mix it up. So now it's time to turn our focus to the Let's Get Technical portion of Birdies Not BS, where we turn it up just a little bit, talk a little bit more technical about the game. This time I want to talk to Cheyenne a little bit about some of the alternatives you have to using your wedges greenside. We're talking about the Solheim Cup. We're talking about link-style golf, wind, rain, elements, putting it off the green. When can you putt it? Can you use a 7-iron, 3-wood? How do you judge what short game shot to use when you're in some of these foreign grasses and these foreign countries?
One, you have to assess the lie. Even though you're playing links golf, you don't always have the best lie. Two, what am I most comfortable with? And three, what is a shot that I can hit with the least percentage of error? So when I'm in Scotland, I have tons of green to work with. I'm going to putt it because the lie is super tight. The greens are firm. And putting, I just feel like if you can keep it as low as you can on the ground, there's so much less room for error.
We American players, we get so used to growing up with our 60-degree wedges and hitting low bumps and high pitches and soft and spinners and flops and super flops. That was the jam when I was a kid. It was about the super flop. And you forget that you can actually just play the ball on the ground. There is a way to play the ball on the ground. You can use your 3-wood to get the ball a little airborne on some touchy lies, as well as using your 7-iron, even 6. I've seen guys use 5-irons to really run a ball, you know, 60, 70 feet to a back pin from a front location. Like, don't be afraid to use the surface to your advantage. You don't always have to play the aerial assault game.
It might sound intimidating. That's why you practice. That's why you experiment. At the end of the day, go with what you feel great about.
I almost don't want to get rid of this episode. I loved it. I love recording this one with you, Shot. But that is the end of this week's episode of Birdies Not BS. We thank you so much for following us and adding us and including us in your posts. You know where to find us, Birdies Not BS on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook.
Or birdiesnotbs.com. Send us all of your questions. We're here for you.